Hey guys, some of you may recognize this item as an item that was pulled from a box in one of my storage box videos. I said I would make a video featuring this little game system, so here it is. The system has 6 games, but only 2 little booklets. I don't know where the other 4 went. Someone had asked if this game system belonged to my son, and once you see me attempt to play these games, I think the answer will be self-evident. Yes, that's supposed to come off. These 2 games in this little secret compartment are from an earlier model Game Boy. But the Game Boy Color can still utilize earlier games. It's backward compatible. Now, I understand the color of this Game Boy is called Atomic Purple. I really don't know how popular the color was. But I find it quite cool. It's been many years since this game unit has seen the light of day. And in just a moment, I'll put some batteries in it and give it a go. Let's take a little inventory. There's battery number one. And battery number two. These are AA batteries. And we'll start off with Super Mario Land. This game, Super Mario Land, was released along with the original Game Boy back in 1989. The ultimate objective is to defeat the Tanga, the mysterious spaceman, and save Princess Daisy. So, have you figured out yet that this game unit isn't mine? I don't even know what that thing is that just killed me. So let's try Ken Griffey Jr.'s Slugfest. We'll do the home run derby. Now, this game, Ken Griffey Jr.'s Slugfest. Well, obviously it's a baseball game. And it was made for Nintendo 64 and the Game Boy Color. And this game was released in 1999. The Game Boy Color itself was released in 1998. And it is the successor of the Game Boy Pocket. And if you don't know, the Game Boy Pocket was simply a redesign of the original Game Boy. The Game Boy Pocket came out in 1996. When the original Game Boy came out in 89. So I guess you would say the Game Boy Color is a third generation Game Boy. Let's try this Star Wars game. This game is called Star Wars Episode 1, Obi-Wan's Adventures. And it's a video game that chronicles the events of the film Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. And it's from the character Obi-Wan Kenobi's perspective. And this game was released in the year 2000. And I really do not have the faintest clue as to what I'm doing. I don't know what these spinning things in the floor do. And I suspect I need to go through this door. And I don't know what this thing is, but I'm just fighting for my life. I guess I need to follow the white line. Let's go in here. What is that? I have no clue what to do. I'm just running around like a madman, swinging my lightsaber. What are those things that spin around? standing in the square did nothing. And what is that thing bouncing up and down? Oh no. Die. Feel free to leave comments telling me everything I did wrong. I invite the constructive criticism. And after I read what you say, perhaps I'll give this game another try. But for right now, it just seems like a flurry of mad button pushing and quiet panic. I don't even know how to make the door open so I can go in it. I feel like the things that are spinning around on the floor do something, but I just don't know what to do. If I stand on them, nothing happens. So let's try something else. This is Army Men. Sarge's Heroes 2. And it's a sequel to Army Men, Sarge's Heroes. This game came out in the year 2000 also for Game Boy Color, as well as for Nintendo 64, PlayStation, and PlayStation 2. Now it looks like I have a little tank. But I'm not sure where to go. And I really don't see anything that I should be shooting at. So I'm basically a clueless tank driver. out for a joyride. That's about enough of that. Let's try WWF Attitude. Hey, now that's got a good beat. Now this is a professional wrestling video that is based on the World Wrestling Federation, which I believe they call the WWE these days. And this game was released by Acclaim Entertainment in 1999 for the PlayStation and Nintendo 64. As well as the Game Boy Color. And I think they made this for the Dreamcast as well. Some of you may remember the Dreamcast. I'm far from being a video game expert or an expert on the consoles, but we had a Dreamcast in our house, and it seemed like it was ahead of its time compared to the other consoles. Once again, I have no idea what I'm doing. I feel like I'm getting my rear end handed to me on a silver platter by this other person. All I know to do is roll. Now this game is named after the slogan of the WWF's marketing campaign at the time, which was Attitude. And it had a tagline that said, "Get it." Well, we got it. And I don't think much of it. Okay, so let's try Dr. Mario. And this game was released in 1990. And I understand the game has appeared on several best Nintendo games of all time list. and I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. I do know that Mario is the doctor and is tasked with eradicating deadly viruses. And this game is classified as a falling block puzzle game. And I do know that the player's objective is to destroy the viruses populating the playing field by using the colored capsules that are dropped into the field, but I don't know exactly how I'm supposed to do that. I can slightly manipulate where the capsules go. And I suspect I'm supposed to put them in some kind of order. So out of all of these games, this is the one I like the most. Super Mario Land, so let's play it again. I suspect I could play this game until the cows come home and still never get beyond the first or second level. And until I picked up this game, I felt like my hand-eye coordination wasn't that bad. But now I'm questioning my belief. Just go crazy. Oh boy. And that was a mistake. I have no idea what I just did. did make it to another level. I don't know what that thing is that just knocked me off. It looks like a big chicken or something. I don't know. And that's about enough of that. So anyhow, this is the Game Boy Color. And I believe it's, like I mentioned before, it's the third generation of Game Boy. I really don't know how many generations of these there have been. I think the one that came after this was called the Game Boy Advance. And I think there's a Game Boy Advance SP that came after that. But I know Nintendo released, they sold, there's no telling how many millions of these. So let me put it all away and close it up, and it may never see the light of day again. I appreciate you guys watching this video. Thank you.